right behind Probst pulls up another boat with previous contestants. And I'm such a huge fan of the show. I'm thinking to myself, okay, are you dreaming?
I just can't imagine you sitting around on your ranch watching Survivor for some reason.
No, it was kind of a dare from a buddy of mine. I had an audition in Austin, so I sent in a motocross tape.
Tell us about your motocross.
I used to spend time with a guy who was really into baseball, and I know who Jeff Kent is, but there's been no mention of him being a former professional athlete who's made probably $30 million in his career.
Well, I'm not one of the pro guys. I don't make any money racing bikes. It's a hobby. How I make my money is selling motorcycles.
I don't think the other tribe members know, and I think Jeff likes it that way, but I will tell him that I know as soon as it becomes valuable to me.
No,
I'm so glad we won. It's awesome. We came from way behind. We went from last to second to first. And afterwards, when Jeff Probst was like, congratulations, I didn't want to run and hug my team. I wanted to run up and jump on Jeff and celebrate with him. I was like, screw them.
Maybe we should play inside games, like on a rainy day at home.
Yeah, we could draw some squares in the ground and rocks.
And rocks and make a checkers board. You guys want to do that?
People should definitely be concerned about me. I'm trying not to make my target too big, but if it's easier for me to align with them and socialize with them by making them feel like they're more intelligent than I am, that is fabulous. I can easily do that. Even my shoes play in my strategy. I went to the store and I bought the brightest, most obnoxious pair of shoes, they're filthy right now, that I could find, and they're playing in my strategy. I'm very, very conspicuous. I'm covered in pink, and you know, I'm loud, and everyone is comfortable around me because they know where I am. They even glow at nighttime.
How many squares across?
17.
What are you drawing?
Making a checkerboard.
We're making a checkerboard.
Awesome.
Any soft cheese, I will.
You like truffle cheese?
Soft cheese,
do what for?
Oh,
soft cheese.
Soft cheese only. Hard cheese.
You should treat that girl.
You know, having six big personalities in a 6x8 container on a deserted island does get interesting.
But now it's a democracy between them three.
At the beginning of the game, there was our 5-person alliance of the, you know, brand new castaways, and then there was Jonathan on the other end, and we were kind of working to get him out. But the guys went out onto the ocean, and they were out there for a couple hours. And of course, what are they talking about? Just them in the water. They're talking about us.
What's going on? Give me the update.
Stop it.
Let's go.
And out of nowhere, Jeff Probst is in my camp, which is, you know, typically I'd jump up and down and maybe jump on him, but it just wasn't good timing, you know. So he was there for Dana, and he brought her to see medical.
Did you not see me today?
You were not good.
I was not good.
You were not good.
I was bad.
Katie sucked in this challenge today. She was no good.
I'm embarrassed.
I could understand that.
I'm embarrassed.
You were not good. But anyway, we have to move on from that.
Katie sucked. Katie blew it. I told Katie she sucked. She knows she sucked. But Denise, she's not part of our original tribe. She's only been in our tribe for 2 days. Maybe I should date this athlete.
What do you consider an athlete?
Football, basketball. Then I guess at the end, maybe baseball. I know, Jeff Kent is a former professional athlete. And as far as I know, I'm the only person who knows. So I enjoy getting into his mind and making him uncomfortable. It's too much standing around. It's like a whole bunch of grown guys just like. It's a lot of fun to make him squirm, and it's a lot of fun to, I don't know, I feel like I've kind of got like a little mouse that doesn't know that it's in a corner, and I'm like playing with it, and I'm gonna snap on it. Jeff Kent, I mean, I could have blown up his spot, but maybe he could be one of those, you know, millionaires who actually come on the show and win. If he wins, he owes me so big. I want a motorcycle, a helmet, a sidecar, and a pink gun. That's what I want from Jeff Kent.
Dawson. Dawson was another very lively addition to the game of Survivor. A little quirky, a little out there, but definitely entertainment that I think Halibut needed.
I played too passively. That's my biggest regret. But having Jeff Probst snuff my torch, I can't tell you how much I was salivating. I just wanted to put a wet one so far up on his lips. It was a moment he and I shared, and I'll never be the same.